moment in time. That you can always be mine.
Oh, I let you fly.
Oh. And we linger on. Oh, darling, 'cause you'll always be my baby. And I won't beg you to stay. I will not stand in your way. You'll be back again. I'll love you and cause you'll always be my baby, and we'll linger on. Gonna shake me, cause you'll always be my baby.
If I can get these open and stop dancing, I'm gonna start this reading in a minute. Try to wake up the building.
I will linger on and on. Oh, baby. Hey. Whoa. Oh, never. No, no.
All right, y'all. Great! Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Wake up feeling, I feel good.
Da-na-na-na-na-na. I knew that I wouldn't have to. Da-na-na-na-na-na. I feel good.
Oh, Lord. No, I ain't drunk and I ain't high. But it is a natural high, though. 420 is my birthday. For those that don't know, now you know. All right. Whew. All righty, let me clear this out. Him. Let me clear this him space out. Space out. Whew. I love that song. I loves me that song. I'm trying to see. Oh, nothing else. Nothing else gonna come on right now. Ooh. Alrighty. Let's see what's on the energies playing today. What y'all got for us? Huh? Okay. Hold on. They said get the singing bowl for y'all. Y'all need a little bit of calibrating. Maybe I need a little bit of calibrating. I don't know. Okay. All righty. Oh, Lordy. I finally found me a cushion yesterday when I was out doing all my errands for my bowl, because I could not get this bowl to do nothing in my hand with the original one. To me, it don't seem like, oh, now it was like brr, brr. It was like vibrating off of it. So I figured it out. I needed something to sit on because of what it's made out of usually. But I did find me one extra one. This was made in Nepal. I found this yesterday because I said this one needs felt on it. It was the type that needed felt because it kept the wooden stick kept vibrating off the bowl when I was going around. And I was like, it ain't supposed to do that now. So I was on the hunt, baby. And I don't think, see? To me, it doesn't do it as loud because of the brass that is on. So I had to find old cushion here in one of them stores yesterday. Enough of the singing bowl. Take that. All right. Into the box we go to see what our morning message is today. Our owl box, wisdom box. And pick out a stone. Maybe one, maybe two, maybe three. To give us the theme of our reading today, right? Okay. Happiness. Happy. Can y'all see that? I don't know. It's dark over here. Happiness. And that is, this is, I'm trying to see if it got gold in it. This looks like lapis. I think this one was lapis. Solidite. It looked like I got a little bit of gold right there, so it looked like lapis. Some of my tape. I washed these off, and my tape is still, where they had the price on it, it's still kind of sticking on some of them. I thought I got them all off. So if y'all see me doing this, I'm rubbing off the rest of the tape that was the price tag. Yeah, this looked like a hint of gold. This is lapis lazuli, and I got my lapis ring on. Okay, let's do another one. Happiness is the theme for today. Beautiful brothers and sisters out there from another mother, another planet, another galaxy. Balance. Woo! So happiness and balance. One more. One more. Hope. Hope. All right. That's our, let me move my cards now. I left them out last night. I'm about ready to raffle off some of them. I got enough now. I can raffle off. I can raffle off on my page, on my YouTube channel. To those I feel my energy speaking to. Let me move these. I'm like, which one else I gotta move? Let me move these out the way. Okay, let me put these over yonder. Okay, now I'm finna get your love and romance. Our words for today is happiness, balance, and hope. Those are your meditative words for today and your theme for your reading today. Happiness, balance, and hope. Oh, those are so beautiful. Y'all should have seen me picking those out. Oh my God, I was in heaven. I was so in heaven. So I'm putting those right there. Now let's get a soulmate card. Happiness, balance, and hope. Meditate. Spirit source energy. What do you have for Facebook Live today? General reading my YouTube channel because it is going over yonder too. Spirit source energy. What else do you have? Spirit source energy. What else? See if it don't get caught on my carpal ring here. Spirit source energy. All signs. Oh, there we go. The love that emanates from my beloved's heart is the light that stems from the mind of God. Goddess, through each other, we become one. I give thanks for the endless blessings that is you. Y'all, how come it feel like we got this yesterday? That's why I stopped, like, why does this seem like this same card came out yesterday? I'm going to have to go back and look at the very beginning because this card came out again. If this is that card, it really feels like that's that card for soulmate. I swear that feel like that's that card that came out yesterday. Woo. So this must gonna be another soulmate reading right up in here, y'all. This is for your rising sun, moon, Venus. Y'all know the spillage, right? It's timeless. So whenever y'all get it in Facebook land on YouTube, it can be 20 years from now. It's meant for you to get it. It may or may not resonate with you. However, if it don't resonate with you, leave it with the eye on my mat, the eye of Ra. And the eye of Ra will know what to do with it. It ain't come with that loud nonsense. I swear I hate that shit. Wish they fixed, not sell that shit. It's aggravating. My spirit don't like that fucking shit. It's ignorant. Ooh, sorry, y'all. The energy had went there. I can't stand that shit. Oh, sound like a... Ugh. Go to a drag race car strip. Y'all want to do that damn shit. Spirit source energy. Ooh. Oh, God dang. They done. Oh, this could be the one. Deception. Oh, yeah. Some of y'all working it, ain't you? Working with whatever you know how to work with. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. We've been having that a lot. Feel what you feel, baby, and let it pass through you. New love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. All right, some of y'all. I see y'all. Trying to get your boo-boos and your baby things on. Children, your love life is being affected by children. Okay? This could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. Damn. Have I? No, I'm just kidding. Hell, I can't tell. Where yet? If I already met his ass. Can you bring them on up in this bitch, please? That's all I'm saying. Show yourself. God dang. Stop hiding in the dark, in the subconscious, and come to the conscious, baby. Come to the light so mama can see you. So I can feel you, touch you, squeeze you, love you. Let me quit. This is what your, what is the title? Now, these are the themes, yes. All those little beautiful cards talking about soulmate connections, right? I want three of these cards today, Spirit Source Energy. I don't want that many. I'm going to do you and your person, where y'all stand with each other. Whatever that person is, whoever you're thinking about your special soulmate or twin flame is, whoever you have in mind, whoever or whoever you're praying about meeting, this new love that came up for some of y'all, it's going to be you on the left, your person on the right, where this ring is at, and in the middle will be your mutual energy between you two. Okay? And even though you haven't met, your person is thinking of finding a new love too. So that's why it's a mutual energy. It's going to be what you and that person are putting up in the universe, okay, about finding that new love, or for some of you, connecting with that soulmate and that twin flame finally in the physical once and for all. And for those who are with their soulmate or twin flame now, or whoever they picked for a significant other, because the universe is about free will. You can marry who you want, okay? Or you can choose to be with who you want to spend your life with. It's what y'all think about each other right now. What is the dominant energy in the universe? And we're going to see what that dominant feeling that y'all feel about each other is. What y'all thinking about each other, what y'all are feeling about each other. Okay, Spirit Source Energy, 3 cards, please. Amen Ra. Spirit Source Energy. Okay, y'all is Amen Ra. Okay. Miracle creation. 2 more cards, Spirit Source. Well, dang. Can a girl get a goddamn shuffle in? They was eager. The spirits, they done gave me 4 damn cards. Okay, we're going to have to revamp this. This is the overall energy. Amen Ra. Miracle creation. Now, we're going to be back on track. All set. Alchemy and healing. Baby. Baby, baby. We talking about all set now. That's y'all all set. I'm Hatope, Temple of Healing. Okay. Basset, Joy and Pleasure. The Cat Lady. The Cat Lady. Now I got to get an under all energy now. Ma'at, Cosmic Justice. Woo, y'all ass is in trouble today. I already know it. I already know it. I already damn know it, baby. Y'all ass is in trouble. You got all set. You got bass set. And you got Ma'at, my girl. Look at him. Look a fucking him. Y'all. Cosmic Justice? Baby, overall, underall energy, Amen Ra and Ma'at, Cosmic Justice. Woo, somebody in trouble. Up in chim. No wonder balance was the middle rock here. Ma'at coming in the building, baby. Ma'at. And back, oh my, ooh, I gotta make sure I'm all right up in here. Okay, I think I got Amen Ra. Wait a minute, y'all, ain't this Amen Ra? I done forgot who I bought. This Amen Ra, this Basset, where's my eye? Gotta move my cards out the way. Here's little old my eye. I don't have Amatope, but I got these 3. And I got the Aya Ra on this net. So that'll be Amen Ra too. That I. Ooh, all set. Baby, I ain't got you. I got Newt though. And here's Newt. God is Newt. Right there. She'll do. Somebody in trouble, baby. Them little rules done came up in this reading today, baby. Cosmic Justice is just about to be served to somebody's ass. I don't know what the hell y'all ass been doing out there, but y'all done got them little rules up in here done came out. My aunt holding that scale, baby. Woo! Okay, let's go. Enough of messing with y'all. Y'all probably like, oh no, I don't want to get it. I don't want that ass whooping. ass whooping. A cosmic ass whooping. All right, spirit source energy. What's going on between them and they person and how they person's feeling? I'm going to try to behave today. Well, I done told my ancestors they need to behave today. They don't need to be showing out today. We're going to be good today. Spirit source energy, what about Offset, spirit source energy? What do you have about Offset?
What does Offset feel about Beset over here?
Their person.
So your person is like Beset to you.
And you are like Offset to your person.
And y'all mutual energy is, I'm her tote, the temple of healing. Because when you come together, the mutual energy should be healing. Should be.
Spirit source energy, clarify Offset. Clap back, snap back, baby. That's my signature right there.
The grand signature.
Knight of Swords. Woo, the magician.
Woo, that strength card. Leo done showed up in the building, baby. Your person beset, spirit source energy. What do they feel about? What does their person feel about them and think about them? Spirit source energy.
Well, that stays there.
Spirit source energy.
What does their person feel about them?
Shit, they see y'all ass as the Nine of Cups. So you see, ooh, there one for Amatope.
All right now, come on now.
Come on now. Come on now. Spirit source energy. What about Basset?
Can we get some cards? Damn, they done dropped all these cards on Basset. I ain't taking all them. Hold on, let me squish these up some. Basset, spirit source energy. Clarify Basset energy. There we go. Spirit source. Oh, shit. Ooh. Wait a minute. Now, these claws are real slippery. That's why they keep sliding out of my hand.
Okay, I got three for there.
High Priestess, Two of Cups, the Sun, double Leo again. This happened yesterday. Justice, double justice, my eye and the justice. Oh Lord, y'all are in trouble. I see why they are. I see why they ass showed up. Y'all ain't in trouble.
Not all of y'all, just most of y'all. Okay, I got to show y'all these cards. I'm trying not to mess nothing up, and I'm trying not to burn myself with this incense. Let me move this incense around here.
Y'all need to see this shit. I'm gonna have to show y'all this shit here. So hold on, hold on. Look at them cards. Y'all see them cards right there? Y'all see how them cards fell and flew out? Okay. I got it goes like into a rope. It tells me it's rotating, so I'll be thinking the phone is not really recording what it is. That's why I was looking at it.
Okay. I need a couple more for Amatope, because your Amatope got two people crossing them. Mutual energy headed toward them. The mutual energy, spirit source energy, Amatope. What do you have? Clarification. I got sage down there on the floor. How did I get sage down there on the floor? Spirit source energy. Amatope. Can I get one card? Spirit source energy. Y'all behave out there in Facebook land. Don't let your feelings get hurt today. Spirit source energy. There we go. Temperance. All right, that's a good one because that's the three up there. The World card. Ooh, y'all got some. Who is? Ooh, wait. Oh, this shit good now. Oh, yeah, this is a good. Oh, yeah, this is a classic one right now, y'all. Overall energy. Love us. Under all energy. The World. Oh, shit. Oh, hold on. Wait 1 minute. Let mama put some bass in it. Oh, I'm going to have to take this off for this. I think I'm going to have to take this off. Well, wait a minute. No. That's too much sun. I'm going to have to put this back on. Okay. All right. Y'all, I don't even know if y'all just realized what happened here. Whoever y'all are, this soulmate stuff, this could be the one stuff, whoever this new love is, this romantic feeling they want y'all to explore, or this could be the one. This could be the one. The children affecting your love life. your new love that you have stirred, a romantic, whoever, feeling in your heart, whoever that is, whoever that be out there, this here, this little one soulmate card, this little soulmate card, y'all, I'm in Ra. What is this damn light? The sun is, it's the way the sun coming in. It ain't coming in today. It ain't coming in right. All right. I'm in Ra, miracle creation. Y'all, that's your overall energy from that deck. Y'all under all energy. Okay. I gotta take this slow because this is a very important message for some of y'all. And I don't want y'all to miss it. Okay. I'm in Ra. And lover's card is the overall energy. Miracle creation. Lovers is about commitment, falling in love. Amun-Ra is like the sun, right? The sunshine, the sun out there. We got so much sun in this deck right now. Y'all ain't gonna believe this, okay? And that one card I still have not turned over yet right here. I don't even know what that is because I'm finna read first. And then that row, that middle row is the last row. But that card gonna stay down because I got to feel where this going. I got to see every card right now because this is gonna be important for some of y'all. The under all energy, the world, my cosmic justice. Look at that shit right there. Baby, I could go on with an intuitive message with just them four cards right there if I wanted to. Amun-Ra is about lovers. The sun coming up in your life is about the balance again, yin-yang, right? The yin-yang, the yin-yang, the tai-chi, the tai-chi, right? That's about the oneness, the creator, the divine oneness. The fact that y'all got Amun-Ra with the lovers as the overall energy and with your underall energy, y'all got Ma'at, cosmic justice, with the world card. Do y'all not realize that y'all soulmates, or who y'all about to hook up with, or who you have already hooked up with, is about to be your cosmic justice for all the injustice done to you in this world? Y'all might want to play that back and hear that part again. Your sunshine, with your that glow of success that you're about to receive with this lover, with this commitment, with this partnership, with this marriage, with this union, is the balance. Uh-oh, here come my grandkids, I think. The little crumb snatchers here. Y'all world is about to be balanced. Y'all about to get justice. Okay? And that is just your overall energy. Hey, Mom. Hey, Gaddy's babies. Hold on, y'all. Hold on.
Go to the car and get
your mama's charger.
Get in the double.
Yeah. How you doing, Mom?
I'm doing okay.
All right, back to this. Hey, sis. All right. Let Granny read. Let Granny do this. Let Granny do this. I'm on live. Don't be frowning up at me, boy. Let me
get too much sweets and stuff.
Yeah, boo-boo. I figured. That's why he was holding his stomach yesterday.
Yeah, because he kept saying it. So when I put him on the toilet, he said,
"Y'all, give him a Gatorade and water. Give him a Gatorade." Okay.
He got it all out.
Okay. All right, y'all. Okay. Back. Okay. Close your door. Hey. Close your door. And all right, back. Okay, family here. So let me get on with this reading because y'all, this is good, him. This is good. I don't want y'all to miss this. I just had to say hello to everybody. So y'all about to get y'all cosmic justice, y'all ray of sun. Okay. Y'all are about to get, to have, to hold, to experience y'all walk in the sunlight. Do y'all hear me? Y'all are about to get y'all cosmic justice. Y'all, the injustice that was done to y'all, people wishing you didn't find nobody, wishing you didn't have nobody, wishing you just live alone and suffer, and they thought that that made them feel good because they wanted to wish that on you, but actually that was wishing them on themselves, which is why they still don't have the person they want or gonna get the person they want. So with Amen Ra brings the dark day, right? Amen Ra brings the justice to the for the injustice of somebody else wishing you live your life in loneliness, in sadness, in misery, right? Your cosmic justice here, soulmates and twin flames, is now arrived. Your balance, your happiness, and your great hope, baby, is here. Do you understand? Y'all about to get y'all walk in the sun of a beautiful sun. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. I was gonna put their biscuits in there and forgot. Get it, Annie. Mama, can you put them biscuits in there, please? Mama.
I hear you.
Bring me a Starbucks, please. I'll cash app you. And y'all ought to cut the oven on and fucking forgot to put the biscuits in there for the grandchildren. I was doing too much today already. Woke up with too much shit on my goddamn mind. Woo, baby. All right, back to what I was saying. Oh, they gonna get their payday. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things are get brighter. Child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things are get brighter. Someday we'll get it together and we get it undone. Someday when the world is much brighter. Someday we'll put it together and we get it undone. Someday when the world is much brighter. Ooh, child, things are gonna get... Okay, now back to the reading. That's enough. Y'all get the point. Y'all sunshine coming. Y'all success. Look at him. Y'all success. Look at all this. It's coming, y'all. Y'all can thank me later. Y'all ain't got to thank me now. You can thank me later with that invitation to your wedding. That's what y'all ass can do. Because I'm telling you, y'all about to be so much of a power freaking couple. You gonna shine like the motherfucking sun walking on mama earth, baby. You gonna be so energetic. You gonna pull so much success and opportunities into y'all. It's just gonna fall and pour into y'all lap. Y'all ain't gonna have, what they say, room enough to receive it. If you don't believe that, you about to believe that one right there. You gonna have so much sunlight into your life, it's gonna be like, how much more can I take? And the energy gonna be like, well, this is all your energy coming back to you, so you already put it out there. You just didn't realize how much you was putting out there, right? You didn't realize how much you was putting out there for yourself. You were storing it up. The wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. I guess that's what y'all ass say in church, right? Y'all about to get that wealth. I'm loving this shit. And y'all about to get cosmic justice in the meantime for those haterators that wished you never have nobody, that you wish you never find somebody, baby, because they couldn't get their shit together themselves, baby. Woo! Now, I'm about to say thank you, Jesus, right there on that note, okay? But y'all know what I mean. Where my Jesus at? Where's my damn Jesus crystal? Okay, hold the hell on. Oh, here it is. my Jesus crystal. When I say thank you, Jesus, it's thank you for clarity, baby. That's all I'm talking about. I ain't talking about no white man. I'm not talking about no black man, no Chinese man, no Caucasian man, no European man, no Nathanael, no monkey, no rat, no horse, no pig. I ain't talking about none of that shit. I'm talking about thank you, Jesus, for the clarity and the trans fucking parency is what I'm talking about when I say it. So don't get the shit twisted, okay? Ain't nothing religious about this one right here, but I'm all motherfucking spiritual. All right, now let's get to the nooks and crannies of this shit, because this shit about to turn me on, goddamn. Oh, Lord, goddamn. Somebody get the water hose. Call the fire department. Shit, I don't care. Goddamn. Y'all don't see this shit right here unfolding? In y'all face. Okay. All right. Let's read on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Back. Gather around. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. We about to lay down the 12 disciples up in this motherfucker for real. Okay. Let's go. Offset, my girl. This is you, y'all. This is y'all, Offset. Baby, y'all are the asset of this person. That means you are the complement to this person over here. Not the slave. Not the vagabond, not the poverty person, not the person that's going to hinder that person. You're an asset to that person. That means that person see your value and you have a high ass value on your body, okay? On your intelligence. Okay, I'll keep going. I'm going to keep going because y'all evidently don't believe this shit. So we're going to let this shit unfold the way it unfolds. Okay, let's get on him. Let me move my little. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Christ. No, I'm scared. All right, let's go. Look at y'all all set. Look at y'all all set. The Knight of Sword, baby. Coming in there with the truth. Your person... You coming in there bringing your person the truth, your person coming towards you with the truth. You are about to just start swinging this sword, baby, declaring everything that is not right. You cutting that shit down left and right, baby. You, oh my goodness. This is the magician. You got the power. Y'all know that song? Magician, I got the power. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm, see the wand? You see the wand? You see the wand? I got the power. That's what I'm talking about. That magician card. Baby, you have mastered, sorry. Somebody don't want me to talk and tell y'all this. So they plant the retro energy is trying to play with my communication right now. Y'all got the power, baby. When I say you are the magician, you are able to manifest anything y'all want right now. That's how much power y'all hold. So whatever it is y'all want out there, you better be precise. You better be clear what you want in this soulmate or in this twin flame, okay? Excuse the children back there, y'all. You better be very, very clear, because the energies that's out there now, y'all have the power in y'all hand because of this balance, this cosmic balance now. And the universe is going to give you exactly what you ask for. If one hair is not right on that person that you want, or that you suspect, if something is out of line, you better change that thought, or that's not the person, and you better create in that person right there at that moment what that out of alignment is. You better clarify what that out of alignment is, because I'm telling you, you're finna create the offset and the offsar that you want. You're finna create that life that you want. So you gotta get it down to the to the gray hair. You gotta get it down. Hey. You gotta get it down to the gray hair. You gotta get it down to the nose ring. You gotta get it down to, I want him to have locks. You got to get it down to I want him to have, you know what, that. You better get it down to his toes better be clean. His feet better be clean. His breath better smell like cherries. I don't care. You better get to the nails are kept. You better get to he ain't got no black ashy ass elbows. You better get to he got a chest with some muscles. He ain't got no gut. He ain't.
Sorry.
Anybody out there hear me? Because you building a saw, right? Is you building a saw? You building a saw, right? You the asset? You already done built yourself. He the one, you got to build him how you want him to be. So, if you want the wand, and you got the wand in your hand, and this was all set needed to build a saw, baby, you better get to swinging that damn wand and saying, I want that joker to have that. I want that joker to have pretty white teeth. I want that joker to breath to smell like strawberries and syrup and honey, baby. I want him to rub me down every night with some honey, coconut, cinnamon, and some glaze, baby, and then lick it off. Do you understand me? I ain't playing with y'all. This energy is fierce. It's so serious.
Will you get that one?
You gonna create, I mean, nothing gonna, this man or this woman that's right here is exactly what y'all asked for.
Oh, I see.
You better know it. You better know it. And if you sent something before y'all get together that ain't right, you better get to recreating. So you better be careful what you're creating. Because what you're creating is this justice is about what you finna receive in this person. If y'all want a $1 billion business together, you better say, and we gonna have a $1 billion empire. If you want a $1 million empire, you better say, we gonna have a $1 million empire. If you say, we gonna have 5 children, then damn it, you gonna have 5 children. I don't care what your age is. If you gonna say, we gonna have a mansion, a $500,000 house, a $300,000 house, this car, that car. We gonna travel 3 times a year, 5 times a year. We gonna live in the state 6 months out of the year. We gonna live in another country 6 months out of the year. I'm telling y'all how to do the shit. How much power you got. Because that's what you finna get out of this soulmate connection. The universe, Amun-Ra, showed up first to tell y'all the sun is now over you.
It's okay. He's just playing.
The high noon. The high noon sun. And my aunt, the cosmic justice under the bottom of you. The cosmic justice. Okay. Y'all ain't got to understand spirituality. I ain't my damn problem that you lost. It ain't. I done explained enough shit on my page. Y'all ought to know what the fuck I'm talking about. So, you got the magician because you hold the power now. You now have the wand in your hand. And to have the wand in your hand as the magician means you've mastered all the cups, the emotions, the emotional lessons, the emotional triggers, the emotional traumas, the emotional setbacks, the intuitive side of you. You learn how to be one with your motherly instinct, your guides. You work with your guides in the motions of feeling, in the motions of neat, net, new, right? You mastered the sword, the work of action, thought, creating things of ideas and thoughts, right? Communication. You've mastered the airways of communication because swords equals air. You've mastered the pinnacles, the value of yourself. You've mastered the type of lifestyle you want for yourself. You saw it, you envisioned it, you felt it, you held it, you let it out, right? You want to be an asset and not somebody in poverty, not somebody of lack. I swear I had that shit, motorcycles doing that and cars. But you see what I'm saying? You've mastered the business mindset because a millionaire, billionaire status comes from a business type of mindset. It's a high vibration. It doesn't operate down here with middle class and lower class. It's up here with high class, middle to high class, I guess, not low to middle, right? You've mastered the one.
Yeah.
You've mastered the wand. Let me put this back, go with that. I'm gonna get to that card in a minute. You've mastered the wand itself. The wand itself is your fire. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, your energy, your passion, what drives you. Like they say, don't look at a man, what a man drives, but look at what drives the man and pick what drives the man. Does the money drive the man or the car drive the man? Somebody tell me. Don't look at what he drives, because everybody flossing and faking and shaking, right? But what actually drives him, okay? And who doing the steering? Who doing the cruise control or the course where this drive is going? With fire, you mastered your creativity. You mastered your passion, where your passion is, where your fire going, where your energy going, right? You can control where your energy going. No matter what happens around you, you can stay focused on what you're creating. That's why you have the wand in your hand as the magician. And you holding it up because what? I'm about to fucking create. Right? I'm the creation. That's the Amun Ra. What it say on there? Miracle creation. You see what I'm saying? So you know exactly what you're creating. You're not without your creation. You're not separate from your creation. You are one with your creation. This represents the phallus. And when you hold that phallus up, that means you're sticking it up in the universe. See? Yahaha. Okay? So now you got a clear understanding just how powerful the magician is when they know they're holding the wand, right? Now, strength, Leo. Leo comes out. This is another sun. So far, that's two suns out, right? Amun Ra and Leo, the strength card. The balance of that ego, just like I said before. And just like balance came out. You don't get the strength card unless you get rid of the ego, unless you don't operate in the ego, but you walk alongside the ego. Your ego ain't the first thing people see. Trying to and dominate and dictate. Right? Now, the Nine of Cups flew out, y'all saw when I was shuffling. Y'all saw the Nine of Cups flew out. I was finished over here with these three. This means you got your wish fulfillment. Baby, the sun, the Leo, telling you, you got your wish fulfillment. Baby, this is serious. Whoever this is, I better have a whole bunch of wedding invitations coming up in him, baby. In email form, text form. Text form, email form, whatever. I better have some invitations because this is seriously, y'all. I don't. Hey!
Just stop fighting, whatever you do.
Stop it.
I'm fixing.
What you doing, man? I got a little old 6-7 month old baby up in here walking like his big brother. Y'all, Kari up in here walking. Oh, he mad. All right, back to y'all reading.
He saw this bottle.
Oh, hurry up and give it to him. Oh, Lord. Lord. Life. Beautiful, ain't it? But anyway, y'all, Nine of Cups is your wish fulfillment. So whatever y'all created with that wand and put up there in the universe, and it touched Newt. It touched the primordial waters, right? That means you made that connection, right? You hit that. You hit that God spot. Yeah.
Like,
that G spot.
What are you doing, Casey?
That's what that means. You hit the G spot. Okay? So when you did that, the universe said, oh, what? Let me get in what they want. They hit, ooh, hold on. Oh, they want this? Oh, baby, you can have whatever you want. Okay? You ain't did nothing but a G thing, baby. Right? So now, let's mosey on over here to your person. I think y'all get the picture about what y'all thinking about y'all person and feeling, right? Okay, let's move over here on this side over here of Bassetta. The nine lives, the nine eyes and the nine lives, baby. All right, Bassetta coming in here. The high priestess, baby. Y'all in tune with y'all nature, baby. Your intuition, your spirit guides, y'all working that intellectual mind, y'all pulling down those downloads, those uploads, them reprogramming and all that, working in that subconscious mind, baby. Because you got to understand, the high priestess is a very, they psychic, empath. You know, they can feel things, they can see things, they can hear things. They can communicate with the dead, their spiritual sources or their ancestors or their orishas, and they're in you, so they're not dead because you're alive. But, you know, we just going to use that term because so the other normal people can or they can kind of understand where I'm going. I won't too much lose their ass. But when I say talking to the dead, I meant talking to the living that's within you, okay, with the high priestess. That means you still have a connection to the spiritual realm, and you have a strong connection to the spiritual realm now, that they trust you and they bring forth sacred mysteries, divine mysteries for you to bring back to humanity or to relay back to humanity. Some of y'all are increasing in your high priestess, your intuition, because you're beginning to recognize your ancestors. You're beginning to talk more with your ancestors. You're beginning to pour libation to your ancestors. You're beginning to thank your ancestors. You're beginning to trust your ancestors more, and knowing that they're not physically gone from this place, that they are still here because they are living through you. Okay, so once you know that, you become more of a high priestess. You become more of a vessel. Okay, for them to download or upload very crucial information, intelligence for this dimension to thrive. Okay, it's not about killing like what we see. It's not about stealing like what we see. It's about the survival of the planet. Mother Earth. It's about survival of humanity and human beings, okay? And those people that are like high priestess and have that divine connection, they are giving certain information. Now, what's so there's different levels of high priestess and high priest and high priestesses. There's different levels even to this card, because certain people cannot get certain information because of what they will do with that information, okay, and because of what they've done in the past lifetimes with that information. So they're not privy to that information in this lifetime. That's why they can be in a high position, but not have no spiritual connection to their ancestors or to that dark secret realm of ancient comedic science or ancient mysteries, right, of the ancient ones, because of what they did in a past life when it was entrusted in them. So they don't have that certain level of power to do certain things. Now, they can tap into some things. And when I say some things, okay, some people go as far as fifth and sixth dimension, third eye and seventh dimension. They can't go above the seventh dimension into the eighth dimension and higher. They only operate right here. That's some of the high priestess and high priest on a physical level. They can see the basic things that you and I or the very high people can see, but their cutoff is here. The seventh chakra is their cutoff. Anything above, they can't access it. So don't get this shit twisted, y'all. That because somebody called themselves a high priestess or priest, it doesn't mean that that's what they are. They can only see far as sixth and seventh dimension. They cannot see from eighth and beyond to infinity. They can't see. They don't have the type of power or the mentality to do that, because with that type of power, you have to have gone through Sirius B test. Okay? Sirius B. You know the doggone star up there? The God, Goddess, God, the star, the A, B, and C, Sirius star system. You would have had to go on through that test. And when you go through those tests, that test is so fucking intense and crucial that some people will not make it out alive when they get done with your ass. So, yeah, they can see auras. They can read your aura. They have the ability to read your aura because they in sixth and seventh dimension, baby. But eighth and greater, like I said, is totally Netaru. It's totally different. And with that responsibility comes a higher accountability for you. This right here. That right there comes with that accountability. Helping mankind. Being a service to mankind. Not your ego. Being a service to mankind. Giving back to mankind. Guiding mankind until so that they can get here. So that they can get clarity. So that they can get transparency into who they are. Okay? And why they came here. What is their south node? What is their north node? What is their karmic lesson? How do they get past the karmic lesson and get out of the karmic loop? Huh? To get out of the time travel. How do they come out of it? How do they resurrect? How do they redeem? Okay? That's the high priestess card. Okay, now your second card over here, your person is the Two of Cups, baby. He wants to have that conversation with you. Baby, he wants to pour all in you, and you want to pour all in it, okay, in him or her, whoever y'all person is, whether you are he or she, it don't matter. This is for all signs, okay? So y'all getting ready to have that heart-to-heart, and y'all see each other. Your person sees you and them as an equal giving exchange, an equal energy, a dual flame, a dual balance, or a dual complement, or a dual reciprocation, or a dual, what's the word, Thunderbird? No, I'm just kidding. Or a dual ma'at exchange of energy. Y'all aren't taking and stealing and sneaking and hiding and falsifying and manipulating and controlling. There's an even balance between y'all two. And both of y'all holding the exact same cup of emotions for each other. That means y'all have the exact same reciprocating feelings for each other. That means you can feel what that person feels, and that person can feel what you feel. And y'all not even be in the same room. Y'all can be clear across the East Coast and the other one clear across the West Coast, and y'all feel the same. The soul feels the same. Feels when you're hurt, feels when you're down, feels when you're sad, feels when you're happy. You know every shift in vibration of each other. like the clock going tick, 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 tick. And all those ticks are mood swings, right? Or vibrations. You feel it with that person because y'all have a same equal cup of emotion. Okay? Y'all are intuitive. Y'all both are intuitive. Y'all speak telepathically to each other. Okay? That's what that shit is. Don't get it twisted. Okay? Now, the sun. There's your third sun. Amen-Ra, the Leo, the strength card. And here's your other sun. The strongest card in the deck. No card can beat this card right here. So when you see this card right here come out, this card right here is saying your sunshine is coming. Your world is about to turn around for the better. Your sun has arrived. As they say, the sun is risen. This the sun they was talking about. The success. This the sun they was talking about. This the sun they was talking about. The success, the green, the money. Okay? They was talking about the prosperity and the abundance. Not the make-believe prosperity and abundance. The real prosperity and abundance. In the form of what? Assets. All set. In the form of what? Your value and your self-worth about you. And you not taking no fucking less than that value. You're going to stick to that value or you're going greater than that value. And you will stay single. Right? Than to take yourself down. Not even a ounce. As the Bible say, a jot or tittle. Of truth, right? Shall pass away where not even a drop or what's the damn word? Ounce of value shall be taken. Right? So now that you've got your son, your person knows your worth and your value, you are the asset. That's why they're beset. It's the sound in the darkness. It's the sun. It's okay. Oh shit, that was powerful, ancestors. The offset, y'all, is the darkness. Okay, let me put this over here so I don't my incense went out. Gotta give y'all this analogy right quick. Beset is this darkness. This is your person, the darkness.
Come on, man.
Like in the ground, buried. You know how you plant something, but you bury it in the darkness? The sun is that white part on that yin yang. Look what your person feels and thinks about you. You are a direct reciprocation of your person, a reflection. A compliment, a twin, a soulmate. Your sun lights up their darkness. Right? Their darkness is mirrored by your sun. It's mirrored. So y'all are seen as duality. Having the balance, that card. Beset represents darkness, the darkness, the subconscious mind. She's a black cat. The sun, meaning manifest into the physical, meaning consciousness, meaning light. So you are what your person always envisioned in the dark, manifesting as this sun in their life. That's how serious this reading is. And damn, you are the justice. You are the justice that person was praying for. You are, thank you. Thank you, son. That you are the justice that that person was looking for, was praying for, was meditating for. You was their cosmic mayat. Let me go back. Balance, baby. that they need in their life. To what? Let's go back. Remember these, you and your person energies can intertwine. To go what? You were their wish fulfillment, their sunshine, their perfect Amun Ra. Whoa! Who is this? Who is this? Who is this? Who is this? Who is y'all? Who out there is y'all with this reading right here? Resonating with this reading right here. So y'all are she got a peacock behind her holding a scale with a feather in her heart, my eye, and with a sword of truth, baby. That mean ready to cut down any injustice. My nose ring on right. Oh. Ready to cut down any injustice. See that sword? The sword of truth. The scale of justice. The scale of my eye. The heart being weighed against a feather. Right? Baby. Baby. Always ready. Hey, son. Damn. All my little chillings here today. Okay. And now. Over y'all mute. Now that's you, and this is your person. Now this is y'all mutual energy. The balance coming in at the mutual energy of I'm a tote. Right? This is about temple healing.
What's wrong with you? I don't even
know. Temple healing. That means y'all gonna be healing in this body, baby. Y'all gonna be transforming y'all body, baby. Into a healing temple, an energy, a temple that is conduit to energy, to serving energy, to mastering and keeping the balance of the energy flow between you and your person, right? Okay, the Hierophant showed up at the top, came across the top of the card like this. That's structure, marriage, balance, law, liberty, making decisions, drawing conclusions, like I said, a mentor type person, a person that someone goes to for advice or to seek counsel, like priests and popes and pastors or high priest or high priestess and stuff like that. That is, mama, I'm recording y'all.
Go ahead.
I'm recording. And this is the Hierophant. Where you finna go? This is the Hierophant about marriage, law, liberty, holding to that structure, okay? It is about let me see what he got in his hand. He got the universe, the galaxy. Ooh-wee! The keys to the galaxy, baby. What? The Hierophant holds the keys to the to the universe. The Hierophant holds the keys to the universe. To unlock what? Dimensions. Well, what's the universe? Your Ori. Your mind. Y'all remember Interstellar? And he, at the end, he had all those locks and all those dimensions in his mind, and he was in that thing and he was moving around and he was trying to get out of it. He was trying to figure out which way to go inside his own mind. That's what the Hierophant has, the keys to unlocking the dimensions in your mind. So you can come out of the low mindset and raise to the high mindset. Okay? That's why it's temple healing. The temple of Amun Ra is this mind. King Solomon's mind. Okay? That is your own mindset that you're trying to conquer. That you're trying to not even conquer, that you're trying to discipline, get structure in, get order in, right? Your thought form patterns, and to reprogram the way you think, because you were, you know, programmed, right? Since you was little. So that card crossed that. Now, temperance. Oh, I'm sorry, y'all. I forgot over here. Temperance was over here after the justice. So temperance was after the justice of your person, which means that's the Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Just meaning be patient, keep calm, keep doing what you're doing. Now, back to this again. I forgot I had said it right here. Across. Ooh, this is deep. Across. This card, this was the card that was upside, that crossed over like this. So I couldn't see it until just now. And it is the Queen of Swords. The Queen of Truth, the Queen of Swords. So this key to the universe from Amitote is the Queen of Swords. You have to be balanced in your thought process. Remember, because swords got to be thoughts. They got to do with thoughts. They got to do with words. They got to do with a person taking action. Taking not just any action, the right direct action. The right precise action at the what? Precise time. That means new focus. That means your communication is accurate. Your communication is sharp. Right? It can cut down a forest of nine wands. It can like a samurai sword, right? You like them nunchuck people and them people that be doing all this with the knives and all this stuff, that you got control and you know the, you know which angles to turn that sword to cut down any illusion or to cut down any falsehood, because you hold the Queen of Swords, right? You're holding yourself up to the truth, and anything else, you're holding up to the truth. It's like saying, bring your thoughts and let me give you some clarity on them thoughts, right? And so you might be so tangled up in your mind with these thoughts that the Queen of Swords can speak. And all of that falseness will go away, and you'll only have the truth sitting in your hand or in your mind. That's giving someone clarity. That's not adding confusion. That's giving someone clarity. And in terms, when you give someone clarity, you give them hope. You give them, oh, now I can see. Now the blinders are off. The veil has lifted from my third eye. Now I can internalize what this is. Not externalize it with the two physical eyes, but I can internalize it and project it out in the right way. Not taking it in from the opposite direction, but taking it in from this direction and projecting it out. Being able to alchemize what I see and what I hear and what I feel and what I sense and what I smell and what this touch is, what this fabric is. I can internalize it. I can alchemize it. Okay? Pick him up and stop. I'm doing a video. But y'all get the picture. Y'all get the picture now? This is very powerful soulmate connection here. This is so powerful here. I'm loving this. I am loving this reading for y'all today. Dang, I didn't know it was going to be like this. Okay, let's see what y'all... Look at the Hierophant sitting up under there. Look at that. Y'all got some marriages coming. And whatever y'all define as marriage, y'all, is fine with y'all. You don't have to get a piece of paper from no court. If you know that's your soulmate, it ain't nothing that nobody can do to take that person away from you. Whatever you define as your soulmate, y'all can do a will and not be married. Y'all can put them in the trust, on the deed, and not be married. You can still, that person can still get what you want that person to have in your will, and y'all not ever married. If you don't believe in that that bullshit system no more of being bonded in somebody's property. That's up to you and your person to communicate with each other how y'all want to proceed with y'all divine union. Okay? If y'all want to remain single but together in oneness and that flows better, then so be it. You define what the hierophant, what the marriage means to you. If you think a piece of paper mean all that, then so get it. If that's what you want, if that's what y'all discuss. Okay? Where you going? Oh. So this is the phallus. Again, this is the wand sticking. This is the physical attraction of this person. Let's see what this challenge, spirit source energy. I don't expect no challenges out of this. I just don't, but we're going to see. Spirit source energy, what are the challenges? Sneakiness, the slickery card. You got to be so slick. I'm going to tell y'all what this means today. Because tomorrow this shit may mean something else. Or the next reading it might mean something else. Look where it fell at. It fell over all set. This is saying to y'all's power couples out here that's about to resurrect and redeem themselves. You can't say nothing about this until your foundation is set. You can't discuss this union, twin flame, soulmate connection with anyone because you have spies, thieves, cheaters, liars, stealers, whoremongers, whatever you want to call their ass, around you. You have to be careful because they're being sneaky, trying to find out certain information behind your back about what you're doing, okay? Oh, what you're working on. You can cut the TV on. About what you're working on. What you got planned. They trying to find out about your... See the sun? The sun wouldn't be right here in this card if they wasn't trying to find out about what you doing, what your assets are, what you got, what you making, how much you make, are you making any money, what you got, what you working on, what's your next plan, because they want to try to interfere with it. So that's why the energy is telling y'all, don't discuss it. Only discuss your business plan with those business people that you working on, that collaboration with. Okay, only do that. Don't discuss it with nobody on the outside of that collaboration. Okay, that's the challenge, keeping your mouth shut. That's the challenge. You know, you got sneaky peeky people around you. The slickery people, they think. But it's not stopping your son. It's not doing anything. This is even some of y'all person is hiding their assets that they even have. This, remember, can be you or the person can swap on this side. Some of y'all persons are even hiding the of what they have as an offset. They're not even telling you how much money or their net worth that they really are worth. Like, some of y'all people are important business owners. Like, they have a lot of shit. Like, you're finna walk into some wealth here. Okay, some of you. Yeah. Some of y'all are finna create it together. Some of y'all are finna walk right into a person that already has it. That's how serious this is. They already got the wealth. And you have, stop, boy. You're gonna tear my blinds up. And you already got the wealth. They already got the wealth and you're about to get the wealth. Or you're already working towards your wealth and your wealth is about to be coming in. And that's why I say it's a power couple here. These are not one rich and one in poverty. It's not that. Not that type of deal. It ain't one with a low mindset and one with a high mindset. A very high mindset. It ain't that. They're both up there. Okay? They're both contributing factors in this relationship. They bring in something to the table. Put it like that. If that'll make the other people understand. You're both bringing something of value to the table. Equal two of cups to the table. that's what makes this so beautiful and powerful. Let's see what the, let's clarify the Seven of Cups. I'm just going to clarify, I mean the Seven of Swords. Spirit, source, energy, what else about the Seven of Swords can you tell us? Your person, you look at, he just finished his Nine of Cups down here. Your person is hiding, telling you you are everything to them. There's your nine and there's your 10. Your Nine of Cups and your 10. This is the wish fulfillment that they feel about you. This is what they're hiding about the Seven of Swords. They're not telling you you are their everything. You are their wish fulfillment, that you are everything they want. They feel safe with you. They want this marriage and this union with you. And they are coming in, sneaking to give it to you, to offer this to you. Your person not even telling you. Your person not telling you this. What is the challenge, outcome, spirit, source, energy? Your person, y'all person not telling y'all. They being secretive they being slick on the reason, because they finna come up in there and surprise y'all ass. That's what's finna happen. They coming to surprise y'all ass, and they trying to keep their composure and be slick and tiptoe around this whole relationship about you, because they're trying to make sure you are what you say you are. That they trying to make sure you are the one. They're very smart, very intelligent. Oh, look at there. There's a soulmate card. There's a soulmate card. They already know y'all soulmates. What's the outcome, spirit, source, energy? Options. The outcome is they think and feel you got options. They know you all set. They know you got value on you. They know you holding the power. They know you hold the power. So now the outcome is they know you have options. And they're hoping, the hope rock came out. They're hoping that y'all can become something still hidden. They're hoping that there is no other options and no other people in the way, that there's nothing being hidden about this, because it's like almost too good to be true. Wheel of Fortune, spirit, source, energy. What about the Seven of Cups, spirit, source, energy? Clarify, tell us more. Woo, baby. Oh, this is beautiful. Woo, this is beautiful. Look at there, the options. And so they're guarded, because they want this with you. They want a happy, balanced home and life and fulfillment and work, and they will have it with you. But they're indecided. They're indecisive about it. They haven't quite, they're going within. They're still trying to get those answers from deep within themselves, that intuitive answer. And because they feel that this is an illusion, and they trying to make sure that this is not an illusion. And at the same time, they see you as you got all these options and choices and opportunities ahead of you and in front of you, like to almost a competition wise. Why would you pick them? Is this the right person for me? Show me that this is the right person for me. Am I not, make sure I'm not crazy here, that this person is who this person say they are. That's your person's outcome of this whole situation. There's the new love and the new beginning cup y'all got right there. The new beginning, the Ace of Cups. Spirit source, what's the outcome? Spirit source energy, what's the outcome here? Ooh, I love when them cars be jumping like that, baby. They be like eager to get out of there. The outcome, the Emperor. The Emperor. It popped right over here on your offset. Your outcome is your person is getting ready to take the lead. Your person is finna stand up and be seen. Your person is finna come out and be seen. You about finna meet your person. You about finna meet the Emperor. The Emperor landed right there.
Going around
where the Ten of Cups is.
Going around.
They're about to take the leadership. They're about to take control of the situation. Okay? Ooh, this is beautiful. Ooh. Woo, baby, this is beautiful. I'm done. That I can't even pull another card on the Emperor. I don't need to. This is about y'all taking the leadership. This is about y'all taking ownership. This is about y'all taking control over y'all life, over this situation here. And this is about y'all coming together. Okay? And building. And this is y'all sitting up in here in this hot... This person has a high position. This person even... Whoever y'all person is out there, your person is seen in the community as a leader, as a father figure, as somebody a lot of people come and rely, kind of like rely on for advice, almost like the Emperor, the Hierophant card here. The Emperor works in that same capacity like a father figure. It's almost like, sometimes to a fault, they can be stuck in their ways, but that just means they're an old person. They're an older, a wiser person, and they got a lot of wisdom. So some things they don't deviate from some things because of their wisdom that they've experienced and had to learn as their lessons. And so they're kind of rigid a little bit on some things. You know, but this person that you have, or even if it's a female, they're looked up as an emperor, a leader. Even if it's a man and you're a woman, your person is looked up as a leader. Okay. It can go either way for a woman or a man, because this is not talking about y'all sex. This is talking about the energy of the card. Okay. There's no gender in the tarot. So you or your person is seen up here. Like people look up to you. People ask you for advice or them for advice. So this tells you the caliber of discipline this person has, of ethics and values and morals and leadership that this person has. This tells you the discipline that this person has. Okay. Just like the magician, this person has that type of power, structure, okay? Their ground is stable. People come to them. They don't go to people. People come and see them. That's how important your person is. This is beautiful. Ooh, this is beautiful. Okay, y'all, that's it. I'm finna go load this book and put this on YouTube. I will drop the link below when it's done, okay? And then I gotta finish up my rest of my 5 readings on their parallel universe. So if you are Leo, Sagittarius, who else I haven't did? Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, those videos will be loaded today on my YouTube channel for your parallel universe this week of June the 7th through the 13th. I'm going to go ahead and finish up those 5. Next week, I am starting back on the 16th, my bi-monthly ones, 1st through the 15th, 16th through the 30th, and then you'll get a monthly, and that's it. And then people that do the most likes, subscribes, and thumbs up on my YouTube channel get the bonuses for that sign. Or unless the energy say, do this sign bonus today because I got something to show them or to tell them, then I'll do bonuses for the other signs. But so far, the main bonuses are usually my Pisces is number 1, maybe Taurus, and maybe Cancer. Get a bonus almost every day in between there. I have to clear my schedule. I got some shit I'm working on. I got shit to do. So I'm not going to be doing readings every day and all damn day and all damn week. Because I got a life and I got shit to do. And I got to free my time for my private readings. And I don't want to be doing all these freebies when I got appointments. So y'all can make an appointment with me. My prices will be adjusting in the future. So if y'all want to get a reading in with your girl, you better get it in while it's $50 an hour. Because it will be going up. The wage will be going up. Okay. As I get, you know, readings. Because I got, my time is valuable. I got shit to do. Okay. I ain't wasting time on people that don't want to help themselves. Okay. So, it is what it is. And you're going to have to pay me first and then email me your rising sun, moon, and Venus, and your question, go to astrocafe.com, cafe.com. If you don't know them four signs, rising sun, moon, and Venus, go there and figure out yourself and find it and email it with me with your question with that damn $50 coming up in there first, okay? And then we can talk. Otherwise, we can't talk. I don't have time to be on no phone. I don't have time to do none of that shit, okay? I don't have time to text. I don't have time to talk. I don't have time to do none of that shit, okay, for free. My time is valuable. So if you want me, get a reading, okay? Get a reading. If you need me, then you come find me because I'm not looking for you, okay? I got too much shit to do, okay? And that's how this shit rolling, okay, from now on. So y'all call, okay? Y'all call. When you ready to work on you and be serious about you and when you ready to face the truth, then you come find me. Email me. Don't come literally find me, but email me because I don't want to see you. I don't want to see you either. Just call, just text me. Just no, don't. I'll take that back. Don't text me. Email me. Email me. You got a question. Email me. Okay? I read my email. Okay? And I read my comments on my YouTube if I don't say nothing but a heart. If most of the time I'm commenting. And sometimes I'm just giving y'all a heart and a thumbs up because I'm letting y'all see I see it and I read it. So that's how that's going to roll. Y'all can take it or like it. Even for those haters, I wish y'all well. I really wish y'all happiness and prosperity. They burning up right now. They mad at me. I know. They mad at me. I can't help it. Get some transparency in your life about yourself and things will get better for y'all haters is all I can say. But they mad right now. So I know they mad at me because they don't like the way I do what I do. And that I can do anything I put my mind to. So, it's okay. I wish them well. I ain't gonna lower myself for their ass. They don't have that to worry about. Okay? And the only harm that they doing is to themselves. Because anything they do to anybody is gonna come back on themselves. So, they better be ready for that shit when that cosmic justice come back on their ass. Because it came out twice on this card. On this reading that we just did. So that's telling you they finna get double justice done to their ass for all the evilness that they done. Okay, so y'all out there, y'all lovers out there, y'all don't have nothing to worry about, baby. Y'all relationship is protected. It is definitely divine, spiritually protected. And your haters, it's nothing they can do about it. But I will guarantee you this. They will get dealt with my eye and that cosmic justice that hit twice. That means they get in double justice on their injustice energy. So they can pray to Allah. They can pray to Orishas. They can pray to God, Jesus, whoever the fuck they want to pray to. Krishna, Dalai Lama, Saint Mary, whatever, or Mother Teresa, Princess Diana. It don't even matter, baby. They can't escape the justice of my eye. So, and it came out twice. So, just know y'all are protected. Y'all spiritual, whatever y'all thing or union is, y'all are protected in that union. Okay? Y'all have that protection. And there's nothing, no person on a physical layer, even spiritual, is going to mess with it. Because that is a divine timing thing, and it has nothing to do with human beings, okay? It don't have nothing to do with this small ass level of human beings, okay? As you know, human beings are not really all they think they are, okay? This has nothing to do with that, okay? And it's all about energy. This card go over here. It's all about energy. So I wish they ass well, even the haters. I wish them prosperity, peace. I wish them love and light into their life. I wish them some truth and clarity. I wish them some success. I wish them some love. I wish they get everything their little heart want to get. Baby, get off my cards. This little boy. Over here trying to pull my cards down. He done dropped and broke my crystal. He done broke one of my One of my crystals, Mama. Get them little pieces up right there before he don't put them in his mouth. Right there against the wall, Mama. And see them two little, them little pieces he just chipped off of there? And the other two down the end. Oh, you sure?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he broke my little piece of little, this little cup. You sure?
Biscuits.
Oh, biscuits. But yeah, I wish them all the love. So y'all, you know the best thing you can do for your haters is wish them some success and prosperity. I know for some of y'all that's hard to do, depending what y'all know what they have tried to do to you. But if you know what's best for you, it's best to stay positive with them. It doesn't matter what they do, because that right there defeats everything they've ever done. Okay, everything they've tried to do, that washes it, you know. That washes you, and that somewhat helps them, okay, see them as themselves, okay. So, thank y'all for watching. I'm finna drink my, Y'all, I got them Buddha teas that got CBD in them. Peppermint and, where I get chamomile. I'm gonna try them boogers tonight. I'm gonna see if they gonna put me to sleep like the regular chamomile and peppermint do. And I'm gonna mix some lavender up in it, because I love lavender and peppermint and chamomile together, baby. That shit is thebomb.com, baby. You talk about relax. I'll be up in here woo-sawing, okay, by the time the end of the night's over with. But you know what your girls say. Okay, what did I say? Hit me up on that channel. Okay, hit me up on that channel, on that YouTube channel, Comedic Arts Yoga and Reiki, the and sign, symbol, and Reiki Tarot. And y'all know what your girls say, peace, love, and harmony. Because when you got peace, love, and harmony in yourself, you got peace, love, and harmony in the world. Baby, don't go. Holding down my spot, and I'm good. Represent, and I'm good. On lock, me, you'll be fine, right? You'll be needing me for too bad. Packed your chose to run alone. Here with me, you had a home. Oh, yeah. You made about coming through. Time we wasted. That's why I had to replace you. Oh, you thought your tender touch could lock me down. Holding down my spot, and I'm good. And I'm good. I got this thing on lock. You'll be fine, right? Baby girl, I'm what you had. Be needing me, but too bad. Packed your chose to run alone. Here with me, you had a home. Oh, yeah. That's the jam. LL and Jennifer Lopez back in the day. Love is all I have. Baby. That's all y'all have.
Need to sit down in no chair.
Is love.
Peace,
love, and harmony. And when you got peace, love, and harmony in here, you will have peace, love, and harmony out there. So peace, love, and harmony to everyone. Hotel.